y is equals to x minus 1 into x minus 2 square into x minus 3 whole cube into x minus 4 to the power 4 into x minus 5 to the power 5. Then we need to find dy by dx at x is equals to 0. See, it's just a continuation for the logarithmic differentiation. The last point 13, we learn the way of applying logarithm and the way of finding its derivative. We learnt all those things, and now again we are going to utilize the power of logarithms to find the derivatives and to find the value. Okay, have a look. Y is equals to x minus 1, x minus 2 square, x minus 3 whole cube, x minus power 4, x minus 5 to the power 5. See, finding the derivative directly involves with the extension of the product rule, but without moving with that, I am just applying logarithm on both sides. Okay, you just apply logarithm. Apply log on both sides. If you apply log on both sides, how the problem will become? Just have a look. Yeah, if you apply log on both sides, logarithm of y to the base e is equals to logarithm of all this product, logarithm of x minus 1 into x minus 2 whole square into x minus 3 whole cube, x minus 4 to the power 4, x minus 5 to the power 5 base e. Simply logarithm of ab is log a plus log b. Logarithm of all this product can be written as this is equals to log x minus 1 base e plus log x minus 2 square base e plus log x minus 3 cube base e plus log x minus 4 to the power 4 base e plus log x minus 5 to the power 5 base e. And again by the loss of logarithm, we have a chance to write 2 here. Okay, just like logarithm of x power n is n log x, with that this is equals to log x minus 1 base e plus this log x minus 2 whole square is simply 2 log x minus 2 base e plus 3 log x minus 3 plus 4 log x minus 4 plus 5 log x minus 5, and the left side it is log y to the base e. Now you just apply derivative. Now you just find the derivative with respect to x on both sides. So if you apply derivative with respect to x, this log y base e is simply nothing but 1 by y into dy by dx, as we discussed in the previous points. Okay, and now what is the derivative of log x minus 1? See, the derivative for log x is 1 by x. Okay, see, the derivative for log x is 1 by x. Then what is the derivative of log x minus 1? Log x minus 1 is nothing but 1 by x minus 1 plus, see, derivative for log x minus 2 is 1 by x minus 2. Actually, for this log x minus 1, the derivative is 1 by x minus 1 into derivative of this x minus 1. Here the derivative of x minus 1 is just 1, so no need to mention. Okay, so plus this 2 is there, and for this log x minus 2, 1 by x minus 2, so plus 2 by x minus 2 plus 3 log x minus 3, 3 by x minus 3 plus 4 by x minus 4 plus 5 by x minus 5. Just observe the simplified version of the problem, just using this logarithm. Okay, our target is to find dy by dx. So dy by dx is equals to, send this 1 by y and it becomes like y into 1 by x minus 1 plus 2 by x minus 2 plus 3 by x minus 3 plus 4 by x minus 4 plus 5 by x minus 5. This is actually dy by dx. But our target is to find dy by dx x is equals to 0. So we need to replace x with 0. Okay, so what to say about that particular value? Okay, so dy by dx at x is equals to 0. First of all, we need to find out y by replacing x with 0. See, this is actually y. Just look at the problem. This is the problem. This is y. When you replace x with 0, what will happen? When you replace x with 0, 0 minus 1 is minus 1, minus 2 square, minus 3 cube, see, minus 4 to the power 4, minus 5 to the power 5. So just directly I will write, see, this from this you will get 1 minus, positive, minus, positive, minus, totally minus. So this is 1, leave it, 2 square, 3 cube, 4 power 4 into 5 power 5. This is this particular y value at x is equals to 0. Then now in this bracket, just think about it. If you replace x with 0 here, 0 minus 1 is what? Minus 1. 1 by minus 1 is minus 1. Okay. Replace 0 here. 0 by minus 2. See, 0 minus 2 is minus 2. 2 by minus 2 is minus 1. So this is minus 1. This is minus 1. Minus 1, minus 1, minus 1. All are minus 1 since there are 5. So this is minus 5. So at the end, this is equals to 2 square into 3 cube into 4 power 4 into 5 power 6 is the value of the derivative at x is equals to 0. So without applying logarithms, it is a bit complicated to find the derivative and the different derivative value at x is equals to 0. But with the help of logarithms, the problem is very simple. Have a look. So another problem of the same category. We need to find the derivative of this y at x is equals to 1. Okay. So I will discuss directly. This is y and it is product of some expressions. They all these are linear. Okay. Now what I do is I just apply logarithm. So if you apply logarithm on both sides, then the problem is simply log y to the base e is equals to, and I am writing directly, log 1 minus x to the base e plus log 2 minus x to the base e plus log 3 minus x to the base e plus and so on plus logarithm of n minus x to the base e. Okay. So now it is okay. Then you need to apply derivative. So the derivative of log y here, it is 1 by y. So 1 by y into dy by dx is equals to, what to say about the derivative of this logarithm? Logarithm of 1 minus x. For logarithm of something, the derivative is 1 by that something into derivative of this 1 minus x is minus 1, because x coefficient is minus 1, right? Plus, here it is 1 by 2 minus x into minus 1. Plus, 1 by 3 minus x into minus 1. Plus and so on, if you continue, 1 by n minus x into minus 1. So now our intention is to find dy by dx. So dy by dx is equals to, send this y that side, y into 1 by 1 minus x into minus 1 is 1 by x minus 1 plus 1 by x minus 2 plus 1 by x minus 3 plus and so on plus 1 by x minus n. Okay. See, you just have a look, y into this is our answer, and we need to find the derivative at x is equals to 1. So next step, what we need to do? What is this y actually? This y is 1 minus x, 2 minus x, 3 minus x and so on into n minus x. Is it right? Okay. So now, this is simply what? Multiply y. If you multiply with y, what will happen? So this is equals to y by x minus 1 plus y by x minus 2 plus y by x minus 3 plus and so on plus y by x minus n. This is dy by dx. Okay. Now what we need to find? Just have a look. Now our target is to find the derivative at x is equals to 1. Since we are trying to find derivative at x is equals to 1, we need to replace x with 1. Okay. But actually, what is y by x minus 1? What is y by x minus 2? What is y by x minus 3? That's what we need to think. Y is all this product, okay? All this product divided by x minus 1. What will happen? Just pay attention, okay? Observe carefully. What is the next step and what you will find the value, okay? So, I will erase this for the space concern. and I will write the step here, okay? So the continuation step from this I am going to write here. So dy by dx is equals to y by x minus 1. Y is all this product divided by x minus 1 is simply 1 minus x and x minus 1. There is a difference of minus. Minus into 2 minus x into 3 minus x into and so on into n minus x. This is the first term plus. What to say about the second term? Second term is y by x minus 2, right? So this is y and all this product divided by x minus 2. So here like 2 minus x is there for y and x minus 2 is there in the denominator. It gives a difference of minus. So the second term is simply nothing but minus 1 minus x into, there is no 2 minus x now because we are just cancelling these two, okay, into 3 minus x into and so on into n minus x, okay, and you will write other terms also. Now why I am writing in such a way, just have a look. Since we are going to find the derivative at x is equals to 1, if you replace x with 1, see, if you replace x with 1, x 1, 1 minus 1 is 0, so this term is 0. Not only this term, this 1 minus x is involved in each and every term. So since we are replacing x with 1, all these terms will become 0 except this first one. Because there is no 1 minus x here, because that 1 minus x gets cancelled with this denominator. Okay, so now I am erasing the second line. So you just look at this. Now what is my answer? So now dy by dx at x is equals to 1 is replacing x with 1 in the first term is minus of 2 minus 1 into 3 minus 1 into and so on into n minus 1 plus 0 and so on. Since all these terms are 0, this is equals to minus 2 minus 1 is 1 into 2 into and so on into n minus 1. So product of n minus 1 terms is simply n minus 1 factorial. So your answer is minus n minus 1 factorial for this problem. You just have a look. You just think about the situation. Okay. How we are applying the logarithm and the way of finding the derivative, and we are finding the derivative at x is equals to 1. Our answer is minus n minus 1 factorial. Now look at the next problem. Y is equals to sin x, sin 2x, sin 3x, sin of 2020x, and then we need to find dy by dx. The same task, since here the product is involved. Okay, see, applying product rule for such many terms is not easy. So you just apply logarithm. So the next step is simply nothing but log y to the base e is equals to log sin x plus log sin 2x plus log sin 3x plus and so on plus logarithm of sin 2020x base e. Okay, just we applied logarithm on both sides. Now for the next step we need to apply derivative. So for log y to the base e, the derivative is 1 by y dy by dx, and here for log sin x, for logarithm 1 by sin, and for sin x the derivative is cos x. So here it is 1 by sin x into cos x plus logarithm of sin 2x. Sin 2x, and it is 1 by sin 2x into cos 2x into 2. Okay. Plus logarithm of sin 3x. Then it becomes like this. 1 by sin 3x into cos 3x into 3 plus and so on. So now at the end, if you simplify, dy by dx is equals to, send this y that side, y into cos x by sin x is simply cot x plus cos 2x by sin 2x is cot 2x and 2 is there, 2 cot 2x plus 3 cot 3x plus and so on plus 2020 cot 2020x. That's dy by dx. Okay, you just have a look.